Good morning, students. So today we'll learn the solid state chemistry. Friends, in solid state chemistry, so first, what is matter? Matter is the association of atoms or ions or molecules are called as matter. Matter is the substance that having definite mass, definite geometry. For example, water, H2O, it exists in solid state as ice, in liquid state as a liquid water, and water steam as a gaseous state. Basically, matter exists in three different states: solid, liquid, and gases. So, question arises in our mind: why matter exists in three different states? Friends, the system contains there are two forces, that is cohesive force of attraction and adhesive force of attraction. In similar type of molecule, that is the attraction between two molecules, that is cohesive force of attraction, and second energy is the kinetic energy of forces. So when water exists in solid state, that is force of attraction between is quite greater than kinetic energy, that means there will be more force than matter exists in solid state. When force of attraction, that is cohesive force of attraction, is equal to the kinetic energies, that means both forces or energy are equal, that situation the matter exists in liquid state. Force of attraction is less than kinetic energy, that means kinetic energy will be very high, then matter goes into the gaseous state. So this is basic principle why matter exists in three different state. Next topic, that is classification of matter, classification of solid, crystalline solid, and amorphous solid. That means this particle or atoms arranged in the orderly definite arrangement, it called as crystalline solid, for example NaCl. And second types of solid is amorphous solid, that particle atoms are arranged randomly, non-orderly, are called as amorphous solid. Friends, in next lecture we will go for the crystalline compounds, types of crystalline compound, classification of crystalline compounds, unit cells and number of atoms present in the unit cells, how we defined from density, number of atoms, number of white space, packing efficiency, etc. We will discuss in next lecture. Thank you.